It's an honor for me to introduce my guru, Dr. Gumawang, Jati, MA. And then today his talk will be about perspective on ICT in teaching and learning, listening and speaking in the 21st century. Saya agak pelan-pelan sambil memilih datang sama. Well, while waiting for others, let me tell you about him. Ada yang sudah kenal atau belum ya? Belum? Okay. Pak Jati is well known as penganggap bebek. So, he goes from one place to another, penganggap bebek. Spreading the virus, laughing out technology and virus learning. He started to fall in love in technology and language learning when he did his master's degree in the University of Warwick, UK. Belajarnya di Inggris katanya. And then after that, he went to so many seminars, workshops, and others talking about the utilization of ICT in language learning. Baru-baru saja, baru terpilih sebelum Donald Trump terpilih sebagai presiden of ITEL. ITEL is Indonesia Technology Enhanced Language Learning. Jadi ITEL itu asosiasi yang mewadahi teman-teman yang suka dengan teknologi dan language learning. Nanti bisa tanya sendiri sama Mr. President. So, ladies and gentlemen, join me to welcome the panel speaker, Dr. Gumawang.
Bisa download saya http.ly.jati dan seterusnya itu untuk yang suka powerpointnya boleh ya. Kalau yang suka main-main so that's my presentation. Kalau mau bertanya tidak boleh katakan, tapi kalau masuk ke go.cl/live/bbjd masuklah ke sana, ketiklah pertanyaan akan dijawab yang kata tangan dan segala macam giliran belakang. First priority yang menggunakan email itu. Second priority, if I have time, then we can do discussion. If we don't have time, we can talk about that. So this is my subject, language learning. The rapid evolution of communication has changed. Language pedagogy has changed. Tetapi dosenmu yang mengajar di kelas tidak berubah, gitu kan? Language use has changed. Tetapi pengajaran bahasa di dalam kelas belum berubah. Bukan. Because now people use WhatsApp, texting, line, play game, so on. No longer talking. Not many people talking, they're busy texting. Right? And then ways of learning. Terus nanti konsentrasinya adalah pada siswa. Ya. New form of authorship for students. And if you use ICT, it should go beyond the cognitive, beyond classroom work, and beyond curriculum. We are not talking about narrative, we are not talking about descriptive, we are not talking about curriculum, but it should go beyond that. Harus lebih canggih. Kalau masih pakai ICT untuk naratif, you'll be so. Gitu ya, tertinggal banget. Yeah. So, use that for something, think about that. Yeah. So, my part of the talk, only speaking and listening skills. Before the internet era, I am up, and then a changing world of internet, what can you do and then possible exploration. So I'm not going to tell you how to use it. I ask you to think about it. I hope when you get home later, you jadi galau. Bermain-main dengan HP, mulai mikir tentang tugasnya, what can I do with my students, and so on and so on. Yeah? So, I will start with this. Can we really teach listening skills? Yang bilang yes, katakan. Can we teach listening skills? Raise your hand if you say yes. Raise your hand if you say no. No hand movement, go home. Tapi gini, saya cerita sedikit. Listening, when you teach in a language lab, the student listen. Okay? And they want the answer wrong. Okay? Then what the teacher is doing? Gurunya apa ini? Giving explanation, right? When the teacher gives explanation, do you think the students become or improve their listening skills? Yang dia mengerti apa? Penjelasan gurunya. Tapi listeningnya tetap aja. Tapi ya tetap kita beli language lab mahal. Anak-anak yang berbeda seolah-olah teaching listening. You don't teach listening, you accompany your students while they're doing that listening. Dan apa-apa. Ya, so that's my provoking question. In the past, we use cassette, we use radio, we use TV, we use WhatsApp, CD, DVD, and then computer. Okay? Apakah ini semua ya? Di dalam kelas, yes no? Ya, some yes, some no. No problem. When you use this, it's structure. You listen to something structure. From simple to difficult. Terus kita mikir, kalau anak baru lahir, mendengarkan bahasa itu, apakah disebutkan dari yang mudah dan yang mudah? So, think about that. Limited resources. Suka gak suka ya yang dia menekan gurunya. Suka gak suka ya yang dia punya di language lab. Whether that's boring, listening or interesting, listening, that's not a bad. Ya? Expensive. It's designed for language learning. When it's designed for language learning, menarik kan? Boring. I sleep in the language lab. It's teacher-centered. The teacher can come and listen to number one, answer the question, so the control is over the teacher. Yeah? Now, listening to the website. There are a lot of listening resources on the website. I'm going to give you some, not all. Tapi intinya semua sama. Yeah? Listening lesson library online. Pasti lebih canggih dari language lab yang ada. L, for example, only one example. www.ell.org. Just like in the language lab. Yeah. Tapi, there is a quiz that they can do it online. If they get confused, they can keep the script. If they get confused, they will get the answer. Sama persis sama yang ada di language lab, modalnya. You have to pay. Masalahnya, gurunya terbaik. Because the student, they can choose what they want to listen. If they want to listen to a song, yeah. They want to listen to a restaurant, yeah. They want to listen to a business meeting, yeah. And then they need to take it to their own, and they become independent learner. Gurunya tidak perlu nemenin kayak orang lain. And it's cheaper. And also, it's provide an active listening game online. So it's like playing game. Turn left, turn right, backward, so just follow that. Yeah? So, audio, video, TV, and website. Website can bring more information, more fun, for the students will have their own choice. Yeah? They can do it on their own. The key of this is motivation. How to use this lab? How to come home and bring them discussion about politics. It's not high interest. Tapi kan tak boleh, kalau yang itu boleh. So there are many. The speaker is not always native speaker. Not always. Artinya kita nggak akan ketemu orang yang berbahasa Jawa. Kita akan ketemu orang kita yang berbahasa Inggris, yang L-nya keluar. Atau kita ketemu orang Jepang yang berbahasa Inggris, R-nya nggak ada. So dia pikir mungkin berbeda. Di language nya nggak ada. They have their own throat, they have no choice. They can choose their own interest, yeah. Their learning style. So giving flexibility for the people. So think about that. Mahal pak koneksinya, lebih mahal koneksi atau lebih mahal beli language lab, terus cari kaset, terus pesan CD dan sebagainya. Think about that.
Capek, megang.
And the belly. Yeah.
Oh, ganti ya, tapi kali gak usah.
Now, video and audio. When you teach listening, a lot of teachers use video. How many of you use video when you're learning? Kada ya? Kada-kada. Ya, there are some. Yeah, that's free movies for teaching listening. There are other materials. Like National Geographic Channel, Epitopia, TED Talks, Khan Academy, and so on. It's very good material for practice listening. The problem is, kadang-kadang punya malas diri itu pertanyaannya. Gitu kan? Terus malas diskusinya mau bagaimana? That's okay. No, no worry about that. An idea. You can use a puzzle. You take a video from YouTube, put it in an espacio, first we can make or we can get questions. Ini software gratis, nanti di espacio download saja. So, the teacher prepare that. Kalau videonya 5 menit, di menit pertama, terus dikasih pertanyaan dulu ke choice. Bisa tidak? Bisa. Espacio. So they can just before they continue. So the student not just watching the film or movies that you choose, they watch and then they answer question, then they continue watching. And then the teacher can see the result. Siapa saja yang mengerjakan? Pak Jati mengerjakan pada semua atau salah semua? Every individual, and it's free. Think about that. Yeah. Also that can, tag-tag bisa juga dipakai. Dan there are two that I recommend to you to try. So you can manipulate this with questions. Yep. Jadi gak usah repot-repot. Jangan disuruh nonton video itu segal pulang. So this one can be done outside the classroom. So it's beyond classroom. Use this inside the classroom. Will not work. So, can we teach this thing? Who say yes, please go ahead. Tak berani. Tak kan berpengaruh pada nilai yang Pak Es. Okay. We cannot teach this thing, not say this thing. But what we should do is, we have to give exposure. Exposure as much as you can. If the listening only inside the class, it's not enough. Give more exposure. For example, you can interpret radio. If you want to improve your listening, so that you're listening better compared to your lecturers, seriously, listen to internet radio. Contohnya, TuneIn Radio, ada di aplikasi, tadi di download. You listen to London, you listen to Australia, you listen to UK, you can do it. And if you listen every day for 5 minutes, or say, or 10 minutes, then your listening is good. Kuotanya enggak, kejar-kejar di lapangan, 5.000. Terus kamu nyontohin di depan lapangan, tuh pingin sumpel, itu tuh BBC. Improve your listening. 5.000 doang, jangan bilang mahal, kan mahal. Males gitu. Ya, so that's an idea. So ask the student to watch, or to listen to the station and you speak in whatever. Yeah? And then ask them to do something. Biasanya kalau listening terus mungkin menjawab semua. Bukan? Kalau yang penting kan, listen to the radio station, what's that and whatever, and then ask them to record. The record will be in poster, digital poster, yeah? Infography, presentation, or other things. Jangan disuruh tulis paragraf. Itu guru zaman filosofi. Guru zaman modern infografi, gitu kan? Poster, session, and so on, to think about that. Anak-anak gambar lah, dengan sesuatu gambar, kerpi, ya. So, listening and video watching, it's not just listen and then nothing, gak bisa. Listen to this and then there is no checking, gak bisa. The student should produce something, so listening cannot be alone. Listening should be followed by writing. Listening should be followed by speaking. Listening should be followed by other things, yeah? But not just listening. It's a critical role. Tadi juga dibilang bahwa itu fakta critical role seperti yang pertama, yeah? But this area yang mengadakan research sedikit, yang mengadakan eksplorasi sedikit dibandingkan reading, writing, dan seterusnya. Operator listening. Karena listening yang bisa diajarkan. So when you do research about listening, do not say it's listening. You have to look at your student response, you look at the exposure you give to your student, you look at the motivation. No, but not the method. The method is temenin modelnya dengan listening. Ya, tadi Christian said, "Network listening has hardly reported research." Artinya masih luas sekali untuk diekspor. Pak Billy tadi bilang, "Taking listening home is very important." So listening, the way listening is not enough inside the classroom, is not enough in the language lab. Kalau nanti ada sekolah lain yang selainnya lengkap, bukan jaminan itu sekolahnya baru. Think about that. Yeah. University with internet speed, face speed, internet connection, maybe that's forever. Yeah. So, learning languages is very safe right now. Kenapa mudah dan terbatas? Internet connection. So, you're looking for Wi-Fi. You don't look for good details. You don't look for good books, you look at Wi-Fi first, and then search what's the game. Okay? So that's the key. So if you have a school leader, then go Wi-Fi. Masa sekolah kalah orang-orang ini. Yeah. Now speaking. Ya, yeah, kalau tanya, ketik-ketik di aku ya. Nanti di berada. Ya. Yeah. Now speaking. From your speaking class, ya, yeah, mau jawab. Coba ngobrol sama tetangga, satu menit, yeah. Setengah menit lah. What do you remember from your speaking class? As a teacher or as a student, silakan.
What do you remember?
Sudah ya, terbayang ya. Activities in speaking class, kayaknya ini ya, gini ya. Sepertinya seperti ini. Story completion, ya. Information gap, describing pictures, role play, reporting, storytelling, simulation, interview, discussion, and so on. Speaking class, jadi lagi di speaking class. Ya, itu bukan sih lagi. Okay, this one is structure. Teacher center in the classroom, limited resources. Kalau topik yang tersingkat, yang atau pura-pura diskusi, gitu kan? That's what happened. Now, provide flexible environment. That content collaborative work. Try to involve each student. Non-correcting the student mistakes. Reduce the teacher's time. Talking time. Kalau ngajar sedikit ya gurunya so give them more practice for them. Speaking, very difficult. It's a very difficult path because it's employing a lot of spontaneous things. Kalau di kelas dia bagus karena dia persiapkan, dia apalin dulu. Artinya tidak bisa dibilang juga sih. In real life, everything is spontaneous. If you don't have confidence, masalah. Oh yeah, masalah. You don't have confidence, masalah. You are not ready with spontaneous answer. What you get, smile. And you don't understand. Or you don't understand. Yeah? So speaking actually is very difficult. Why is speaking is very difficult? Need a lot of spontaneous things, subconscious things, need a lot of other knowledge. Website. So, the website, if you want to speak to your mom, you go to myenglishteacher.eu, speakme.com, and also, some of the sites you can download in your mobile. Kayak Android, kalau coffeestrap.com, ada webnya, ada Androidnya, ada iOSnya. So, this is speaking community. That's what the difference. When you log in, you join the conversation, you can speak, you just comment. Then you can find somebody else that you don't know, somewhere in the globe, somewhere in the US, somewhere in China, you can choose. Then you can start discussion. So you can do that. And for the sudah pintar speakingnya, tak semua apa lagi, no idea. When you get here, you got real audience, you got real people. When a role play, it's not real. Yeah, this one is real. So try that if you have time, or try that in front of mama. Yeah, this one. You can talk to your mobile phone as well. It's called application artificial intelligence. AI is artificial intelligence. This machine can answer almost everything. Download namanya Siri. Namanya Siri kalau di iOS. Kalau di Android itu ada assistant namanya. Ada assistant, ada Eva, ada Tim, ada Robin, dan lain-lain. Let's become your assistant. Sekarang saya tanya, kalau konsen alarm pagi pagi itu buka dulu menu, terus pilih jam, terus lihat alarm. Itu zaman Majapahit. Zaman sekarang yang pakai AI itu download di mobile iOS or Android. You download assistant, then you speak. Terus dia bisa alarmnya. If you ask person, where am I? Terus dia masih pertanyaan kamu di mana? Where is the nearest hospital? Then this AI will answer it for you.
Belum tahu ya?
And then you start thinking 40 things speaking. Where my students?
Saya ngajar di ITB. Minta mahasiswa,
tolong tanyakan pada Siri atau asisten yang membuat dia marah. Lu kan tanya terus, practice is speaking. Try a lot of questions. And then telling me, this Siri cannot get anything.
Are you sure?
Aku nyoba dulu lah ya.
Are you sure?
Yes, no. Try it again. Gimana tuh Big Bang? Practice asking questions. Speaking here and also practice listening. Because this AI, artificial intelligence, very smart. Spoken. You can just send SMS.
They will say, who should I send it to? Say, Finita. What should I say? Or what do you want to say? Then I said, go quickly. Or kill yourself. And then finish. Should I send? I said, yes. And then send. So you have a very smart artificial intelligence in your mobile. Tapi kita nggak tahu apa itu ada. Karena kita tahu. Then how should we use that for speaking? Tinggal pinter-pinter yang kita ngakali muridnya. Ya, so let's be honest. Interpreter. Right now, there is interpreter in your mobile. You get down with it. You can type a text. What's coming out? I'll be in the language. I did it last time in Vietnam. Speaking of Vietnamese, I put my mobile in the middle. I say, selamat sore. And keluar bahasa Vietnam. Vietnam yang ngomong, keluar bahasa Indonesia. So that's interpreter. Yeah. Think about that. To have a role play with the student. Jadi, Pak Jokowi gak perlu interpreter yang datang. Dia perlu handphone bagus, sama koneksi internet kerja juga. Inilah. Ya. So that's all the things that you can do. Again, jangan di kelas. Kalau aktivitas kayak gini di kelas, rame kali boleh dengar. Do it outside the class, then give it another class. Kan tadi, speaker yang tadi bilang, creativity. Ya. Mr. Wood from Brunei, saying that creativity demands both teachers and students to step out of their traditional role. Jadi jangan ikutin kalau gaya atau mengajar, atau kalau yang berbeda. Pasti tidak dipikirin. Ya, teori jauh itu khusus luar kan? Sekarang sudah 2000 berapa? Ya, so you have to step out of that, explore. Yang saya kasihkan tadi, dicoba. Ya, beyond basketball. So, provide as many opportunities for the learner to develop their speaking and target topics. Put that in real. Yeah. That might be important. Yeah. Popular software. Photo story. Photo story. Sudah nyoba? Sudah. Photo story is series of pictures. Then the students will tell the story about the pictures. Click done, come out, become a video. After that, then upload the video in YouTube. So it's become real. Jadi kalau jelek, tidak akan diupload. So make it the best. Because you're going to be uploading, your work is going to be uploaded on YouTube. And then from that YouTube, you can using at Hustle tadi untuk listening di kelas. Yeah. Think about that. Screencast, how many of you familiar? How many of you familiar with screencast? Enggak, harus punya. Tapi yang mudah-mudahan. Screencast, intinya adalah semua yang ada di layar bisa di capture. Terus diisi suara, terus menjadi lecture nantinya bisa menjadi cerita dan sebagainya. And then you can upload to YouTube. If you see my YouTube, it's a lot of screen capture. Kerjaan mahasiswa. Mahasiswa writing, ngirim lewat email, tak taruh di layar, tak screen capture. Terus tak mau lagi. Your topic sentence is very good. Your English is very good, but the content is not very good. Rewrite it, tak aku berhubung. Lupa saya malu, ya salah aku berhubung jelek. Ya, so I give feedback to my student using this in YouTube. So the student can revise my input anytime, anywhere they want. For another improvement. So, I do that very often. Ya, very cheap. FIFA video, how many of you familiar with FIFA video? Yang muda-muda, sudah ya? Think about that for teaching. What can you do for teaching?
What topics can you give to your students so that they reach people with you and then they upload it again? You can do that. Bayangkan kalau speakernya di kelas doang, pura-pura doang, gak ada yang nonton, gak sama. Ya, kalau dia itu Clary Scans. Tadi yang lebih sedikit yang beda kan. Ya, so you use Clary Scans, picture, telling, and drawing, and so on. It's very good for elementary students. They love it. Then they can publish it in Clary Scans, they can publish it in mobile. Okay, they practice speaking. The task for the teacher, they get buzz, they get motivation, and so on. Yeah? And when they practice their speaking, gimana? The class? No. They do it outside the classroom wall. Okay. So, when you use software, when you use application, it's not only for listening and speaking. Listening and speaking bisa dilakukan lewat research dulu kan. Sebelum ngomong dia sudah baca buku. Setelah dia ngomong dia suruh nulis. Setelah dia nulis organization skillsnya dan sebagainya. So it should involve other skills, not just speaking and listening. Think about that. Yeah. So by doing a project or simple task, you can teach. You can get opportunity for your learner to practice almost all of those skills. So, thank you very much. Let's begin again inside the classroom. Maybe yes, maybe no. Maybe a little, maybe motivation. You have to think of the activities beyond the classroom wall. And they practice more, they interact with more people, they produce something for real audience. Yeah. What they're looking for? Wi-Fi. Free Wi-Fi and free connection. So, that's all what I can say. That's my email, gumawang@gmail.com. Describe my life. If you have any questions, complain whatever, email me. Saya selalu balas email. Ya, that's my Facebook. Boleh baca lewat itu, boleh baca Facebooknya boleh. Tapi itu kumpulan orang tua. Jadi obrolannya obrolan Facebook, kumpulan orang tua, kejelas-kejelas itu kan. Saya ada di situ tetap juga. Apa-apa. If you have Twitter, that's better. Yang mudah-mudahan bisa di Twitter group saya. Ya. If you want to download my presentation, you can go to bit.ly. Yeah, there are some questions. Belum selesai pertanyaannya dari sini, tak baca yang dulu. Dear Pak Jati, how to feel with low motivated? Sorry, to say student who said that I don't like English. I can work without learning it, thank you. If students say, don't have any motivation in English, then tell a story. Tell a story in Bahasa Indonesia. Kalau Bahasa Indonesia itu penting. Kalau pengen jadi PNS, gitu kan? PNS doang. Gak kemana-mana. Gak punya temen. Gak punya. Gak pengen ngerti YouTube dan segala macam. Gak apa-apa. Gak akan mati waktu itu. Sudah bencilah Bahasa Indonesia. Maksud saya tunjukkan bahwa dunia ini kalau tidak tahu bahasa Inggris tidak bagus kan? Gak bisa nonton film kok, gak asik kok. Kamu dengerin lagu nggak ngerti artinya, ngapain gitu kan? Harus pakai bahasa anak-anak kira-kira. Could you explain how to increase our desire and listening? Desire and listening, how to increase? Gak tahu saya. Kalau punya motivasi untuk mendengarkan apa itu yang paling utama. I don't like Indonesian radio. Itu nggak dengerin. I like more British radio. I listen to British radio a lot. I don't like Australian.
Empat tahunnya ke dokter kayaknya. Can you give us example of anything that improves the skills in speaking? Tadi sudah teknologi, artificial intelligence bisa dipakai, namanya Siri atau assistant. Yeah. A lot of websites that you can use. Project using large scans, using screen, using apa saja itu tentunya software-nya ada banyak sekali. Give them task, real task, and then they do it in group, they process it, they upload it in YouTube. Kata kuncinya itu, dicoba dulu. And this application can be used to improve the speaking skill. Ya, tadi sudah ya. Aplikasinya banyak juga, bisa lah. The key is not in the apps. The key is not in the software. The key is in your creativity. Sebagai guru, mau dikasih tugas apa? You have to stand out from your routine. Itu yang penting. You have to stand out from your curriculum. Tadi kata aku nyebut ya, ada curriculum, ada classroom. Harus keluar dari situ untuk berpikir kreatif. Tanpa itu, you can't. Kalau itu buruk-buruk ya kembali naratif, kembali perspektif, kembali roleplay, kita tambahin duitnya juga sesekali lah, tidak harus terus-terus dan sesekali perlu sekali. Oke. Oh, hands still to face. Oke, okay. Any questions? Ada pertanyaan? Oh, ya.
Bahasa Indonesia boleh. Saya boleh. Saya maaf. Saya ingin berbicara dengan Sarah dari Gumawang University. Regarding these presentations, I personally feel interested in this patient. And when I learned from how I gain more improvement is from debate. So what I learned from debate, I gain more skills together in one package, like with listening, reading, speaking, and writing for a good use of time. And sometimes, because I teach too, like sometimes I want to try to apply debate in to my students, but the problem is sometimes they feel like debate is that scary, so forth, and how we overcome that kind of unmotivated and unmotivated, and so on and so forth. In regard to the debate itself, because what I feel so far, I made my improvement from debate, especially for the space and stuff. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so your question is about debate and how to. What if it's good so that they come to a debate class? Yeah. Debate should be controversial issues. If you're not interested in the issues, people will not debate. Why? Number two, maybe your student, they don't have enough background. Yeah. When they don't have enough background, then what can I say? Mungkin bahasa Inggrisnya bagus, cuman yang mau tak mungkin apa? Okay. Mungkin itu, so think about the level and think about their knowledge. Kan tadi saya contohnya, knowledge untuk speaking is not easy, because it's spontaneous. Ya, bukan pura-pura aja, kan dia lah. Answering your question. Mungkin tidak. Ada yang
I asked based on my experience. Before, when I used Grammarly is the website that could check that our grammar correct or no. I never tried when I used that software, we call it software Grammarly, and then I checked that it has some limitation. I understand that's not grammar, but that Grammarly read the wrong way. My question is, it has limitation also in interpreter because it's really useful at writing. It's like Grammarly, it has some limitation or in 100% valid in England.
Okay, 100% valid on that. So much that I tried with interpreter, so far it's okay, but it's under development. Especially the spoken one. Kalau yang speaking-nya itu ditaruh di tengah, dia terlalu sensitif. If you are in a restaurant, somebody else says something, then try to translate that one. Yeah. But the one that's typed, that you have to type in certain sentences, that's pretty accurate. So explore that before you use it. Ada? Question? Yeah.
Thank you very much. It's really interesting to pay attention to the visual intelligence. And I think it's a new thing for me to hear such a term. I want to know what is the basic philosophy of artificial intelligence. Is it related to the cognitive linguistics or any other theories of language such as or statistics or geography analysis. That's interesting. And another question is, if we cannot reach this thing, how can we guarantee that our students can improve their ability? And then they can also use their listening skills to
Artificial intelligence is not related to cognitive or linguistic or whatsoever. Artificial intelligence is a computer program, programming big data, trying to imitate human brain. Kata kuncinya itu. Jadi kita tanya apapun cepat dia terpakai punya pusat tapi dia sangat cepat dengan kecepatan yang itu kan and then they produce. So that's now is getting popular. Cerita sedikit, 2 bulan lalu saya baca di ekonomis US, kalau interview, yang menginterview pertama stop dulu, robot. Kalau lolos dari robot, baru diinterview orang. Gitu. So, they use it for that, yang terpengaruhnya salah satu. So, that is second question, yang dikira kids listening, give exposure, the key is that, give exposure to your masalahnya di Indonesia itu kan kalau listening sama speaking we don't have enough exposure. Kapan dengerinnya? Dia tidak boleh selesai dalam 4 tahun kuliah pergi ke Indonesia karena cerita cuma berapa jam satu terus yang dengerin tidak tertarik-tarik amat berarti gak dengerin kan minus 1 lagi dari video. I'm just kidding. And the same as speaking when you try to speak in English outside your class, dikira orang cantik, diketawain orang, dilihat orang, dilihat sok-sokan gitu kan. So, there is alternative website, talking to your people, talking to artificial intelligence. Contoh, anak saya sebelum ke Korea, tidak khusus baca Korea, dia khususnya sama Ethiopia. Ya, dan dia bisa pergi ke Korea, tanpa diambil siapa-siapa, and he survived. Kuliahnya bahasa Inggris, cuman kalau tidak ada pesan saja. Nah, when kita about listening and we talk about speaking, in the real world, the interview is no longer face-to-face like this for students. They have to upload a short video, 3 minutes video about her or himself, and 3 minutes send it to the company. Kalau pelamarnya tadi bilang, kalau pelamarnya komunikasi pelamarnya. Ya? So the speaking is not just but how can you condense how good you are in 3 minutes? the curriculum is not the language maybe, but what to say. So it's not a skill. Yeah, so think about that. Speaking is the how you perfect your words, your name, how that you want to prolong your network. How to promote yourself. Yeah, so think about that. The world is changing. Katanya, perusahaan taksi terbesar di dunia apa? Uber. Uber kan? Punya taksi kan? Dia nggak punya. Uber perusahaan taksi seluruh dunia. Dia nggak punya satu taksi pun. Yang dia punya apa? Aplikasi. So, the whole business is changing. Kalau the world disappear, ya kan? Yang kerja di sipil juga nggak laku lagi. Sudah masalah kan itu. Dan toko Siki bentar tadi tutup. Kantor pos sudah tutupnya lama. Itu kan? Banyak sekali pekerjaan ini. Banyak sekali pekerjaan ini. And they need English. And not just English. Inside the classroom. But English in real world. Thank you for that. So my advice would be use your mobile. Get connected. Talk to the people. There are many things that you can do. Think about that to get the advice for you. The activity, think about that. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for joining Jati for the